carry on casting. So I've decided to fish a pool I've never fished before. I never even knew about it until the other week. It's called Rosehill Carp Fishery. It is carp fishing only, no match fishing. The pool's just over there. I'll show it to you in a minute. Got all my stuff on the trolley. That's supplied by him. Richard, his name is. Really nice guy. Just showed me around the pool. I just thought I'd show you this place first. This is called Angler's Lodge. And this is just for the anglers, look. So you've got microwave. And a bit of fat fry there. Table. It's TV. You know. Darts board. And this here is just for the anglers, like. If you have a look at some of the fish that have been caught. Some lovely fish. And this place, it's just for the anglers only. This is Richard, he's the owner. The showroom for the anglers. As you come in. Basin. The toilet. Look at this, eh? Where else can you go that can offer you this? £20 a night, eh? Brilliant. That's quite a workout, bringing that round here. But so I'm fishing on peg number 4. So each peg, it's got its own little map and it tells you what number peg it is. So peg number 4, basically, it's like all of this, all the way, probably to there, you've got all of this water next to me. This is peg 5. So basically you got under the tree, all the way out to the island, under that tree, and again all the way to the island. So you've still got a fair bit of water. So basically all of this to fish. So I've just casted out my first rod. I've chucked a fair bit of bait out. See where that tree there, this one here overhangs. So just underneath, probably around about here. I've heavily baited up the area. That's where it'll stay now, at least for a good few hours. The other one, I'll probably just go straight out into the middle, I think. And then the other one, I'm just going to stick to the margin. I'll probably just have it underneath this tree, maybe. What I do like, if you're a smoker, I've got some little buckets there for your nubs. And if you haven't got a bucket with you for your fish that you catch, to keep them nice and wet whilst they're in the cradle, it does supply a bucket as well. So, yeah, very impressed with this place. It's going to be a nice, relaxing session. Hopefully with a chance of a fish as well. About to cast my second rod out. I just thought I'd show you my rig. So I've just got a slip D rig on it. Let's focus that in a bit, if it will. Probably not. There we go. And I've just got a bloodworm on this one with a corn topper. Source on that one. I don't know whether to go for the life system or the Scopex squid on the third one. I'll decide in a minute, but all my rigs are going to be pretty much similar. I've just tied myself a little PVA stringer to cast out, and then I'll also cast a few freebies out. So I'm going to get this one out, get my third one out, sit back, relax, and enjoy. It's all three rods out now. Busy setup, just sitting down, got the sun shining down on me, just relaxing. What a beautiful place. Never even knew it existed. Obviously it's all by appointment only, so if you did want to fish it, you'd have to message him on Facebook. The Facebook page is Rosehill Carp Fishery. When you get here, ring the bell and he'll let you in. Your car is locked on here. If you need him, you can just go and find him, and you know, he'll help you out in whatever way. if you're short on gear. He turned around to me, so if you're short, if you forgot something, come and let me know. And if I got it, I'll let you use it. Brilliant place. I love that lodge. You know, if you was doing a few nights on here, you know, if you just wanted a little chill out, away from your rods, sit down, watch a bit of TV, cook something in the microwave, have a game of darts. Brilliant. It's got shower facilities. So if you do spend a few nights, you can have a shower. He does provide bait as well. He provides mainline baits, sell, I think he was saying, and essentials. Does it look down here though, you know? I'm literally, now this tree overhangs, it's just here. He did say, from where, that yellow bush bit is there, like four wraps out, when there was clearing the silt out of here. He said there is like a gravel bar that runs along, so if you're fishing on that side, just four wraps out, that's a spot where you'd need to be. He said the margins are quite deep in here, so there's no waders allowed. A fair few showing. There are smaller ones in here. And he's trying to get like the bream and stuff like that. He is trying to get rid of them. He has netted the pool before, but there are still bream in here. And there's a little pool just over the back. So if I do catch them, just to put them in that pool. Another thing is no bait boats allowed. You can use micro barbs and barbless. You can use short lead core leaders. No braided line, but you can use braided hook lengths. £10 minimum break and strain on your line. Large mats or cradles, large landing nets, slings, and carp care kits. Yeah, it's quite ideal, this back end is, especially if there's two of you. You've got me covering this side of the water, got my bivvy here, could have a mate fishing here, covering this side of the water. Obviously you've got the nice island just in front of you. Get your bivvy set up here. Spot for two of you, definitely. We'll be right back. Just had another beep on that one. Come on, fishy fishies. It's going up to 6 o'clock now. The rod's in the water, well, about 4.5 hours now. These two on the left. Checked them, I've just left them where they are. I think that's where I was going to leave them. And the one I messed about with really is this one here. See, I think that's just smaller fish, I think. That's only started happening since I put the robin rod on. So, see what it is it's sniffing, if I catch it. If it does turn out to be something small, the boilie will be going back on. Well, nothing materialised on that right rod. I had a couple of little runs, but I think they were just smaller fish, I think. But we'll never know. I'll swap back over now to a boilie. It now, it's out for the night. I'm just coming, sat inside my bivvy. It's just started spitting a bit with rain. Hopefully, it won't be too heavy. I don't think it's forecasted, so fingers crossed for a good night. Just had a blip on the middle one. Had a few blips on that now, so hopefully, the feeding around that area. Come on, fishy fishies. Well, it's 3:30 in the morning. There's a screamer on the left rod. Not had a bleep on it ever since it's been out. It's been out since, what, 1 p.m. yesterday. Just had a screamer on it. My buddy flip-flop come off. Buddy went running out. And now I've got a wet sock. You're gonna have a wet foot. Anyway, did all the hard work. Obviously tiptoeing about, line went a bit slack. Rookie mistake. Bloody fish come off. It felt a good one as well. Gutted. That was what. 12 hours in the water. Come on, let's try and get one.
Well, it's coming into about 6 o'clock. Had about another hour and a half sleep, but I've woke up right bunged up nose. Perfectly warm though. Nice and wrapped up. Good thing I missed that one at 3:30 this morning. My bloody sliders fell off, didn't they? Foot was getting wet and I was trying to get it dry again by standing on the wooden plinth. You let it get slack just a little bit, like, you know, and come off. Still pitch black. The dark mornings are here. Still got about another 6 hours or so to go. So as soon as it gets light, I'll recast my rods back out. Hopefully I'll get another run. Catch up with you in a bit.
7:20, it's still blooming dark. Starting to get light, but it's still too dark to recast my rod today, because I can't see where to get them bob on, if you know what I mean. The light is coming up over that side though, so hopefully, well, I'll give it about another 20 minutes, it should be light enough. All three rods over again.
Now we just sit and wait. Almost had one in the night. Or should I say early hours, 3:30. Gutted still. Would have been nice to have caught my first fish on a new venue. It felt alright, but I think all fish do in the dark, don't they? So we'll never know. It's a lovely morning. Bit of drizzle. I think that's going to pass. Still got a good few hours. So hopefully one of them will rip off. Fingers crossed.
It's about 9:30. Still got a few hours left till about 1:00. Feeling a bit rough this morning. I think I'm coming down with a cold. Still gutted I lost that one early hours in the morning. I'm hopeful that I'll still get another one before I go. But if not, just look at that, do you know what I mean? Such a beautiful place. I'm already looking forward to coming again. In that time of year now, isn't it, you know, where it's going to get harder anyway. It's like yesterday, it was what, I think it touched 17 degrees yesterday. So with the temperature going cold and, you know, mild and cold and mild, it's going to switch the fish off. But yeah, I see myself doing a few sessions on here. Hopefully anyway, a few hours left, fingers crossed. I'll get back to you in a bit. So I'm just trying to battle through this last hour and a half with this man flu that I've developed overnight. Wind direction seems to have changed. Now I'm just wondering whether they'll end up pushing the fish this way or whether they'll end up holding up over the back where it's calm. Time will tell, eh? But we'll give it another hour and then we'll have a walk around the lake, have a look at the pegs. And then we'll probably call it a day. So I'll speak to you in a bit. Well, that's me all packed up now. But before I go, I thought I'd just go around and show you all of the pegs. Starting off with peg 10. Just turn you. These first three pegs, I say the first three, 10, 9, 8, you can actually drive on through this gate here and you can actually park by your peg. This is peg 10. Hopefully you can see okay because of the glare. Looking at peg 10, you've got literally a lot of water to play with there. I think that one over there, that's like a private peg, because that's not on the map. Let's see if we can focus into it over there. Got. It might well be a peg, it might be peg one. And your next peg. Peg 9. Again, a little lot of water to fish to. Looking quite deep right in the margins. So there's 9. All the way to the island there. So it's peg 8. A bit tighter, but you can still get three rods on, no problem. You know. Under the bush maybe, on either side, straight out. Like I say, if you look on here, there's a fair bit of water to play to. Straight to the island. Peg 7. There you've got, I think it's peg 2. Yeah, that'll be peg two then. Let me think, hold on. Yeah, so I think that one is a private peg over there. I think that's peg one. I think that's peg two. I think that's peg three. Windy. Right. Six I do like the look of. And I think I will give it a go. Maybe next time I come. Some nice features here. Again, another peg. That's good if you're fishing with a mate. Pegs four and five. So with five, you've got all this here, straight out to the island, and then we're off the ship. So I had a couple of bleeps. I hooked into one, schoolboy error. Slap the line off and the hook come out of the mouth. But you know what, on a water that I've never fished before, I think hooking into one fish is an achievement anyway, you know. I think I need a few more sessions on here just to learn the water, test different baits out. But there's definitely fish in here. And what I'll do is at the end of this video, you'll see, I'll post a few fish, pictures of the fish that are in here, a few of the carp, some beautiful carp. Well, anyway, thanks for watching. Until next time, carry on casting.